हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट योर सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ योर मलबरी बुक। द नेम ऑफ योर सेकेंड चैप्टर इज द विज़र्ड ऑफ हॉकी। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। विज़र्ड ऑफ हॉकी। सो बेसिकली द विज़र्ड ऑफ हॉकी मीन्स दैट समबडी हु हैज़ स्किल्ड द आर्ट ऑफ प्लेइंग हॉकी, राइट। पेयर दिस पिक्चर्स रिलेटेड टू गेम्स एंड स्पोर्ट्स विद द राइट वर्ड्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग योर चैप्टर देर इज़ एन एक्टिविटी फॉर यू स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव टू डू इट बाई योर सेल्फ। सो दे आर सम वर्ड्स विच इज़ रिलेटेड टू द गेम्स और स्पोर्ट्स, सो यू हैव टू मैच दैम विद द करेक्ट गेम्स एंड स्पोर्ट्स। ओके, नाउ लेट्स रीड द स्टोरी। There is one such person that our country India is proud of till date. We will read about him in this chapter, and his name is Major Dhyanchand Singh. Major Dhyanchand Singh has done India proud by playing Olympics, and he has been in the team of India for hockey and won 3 gold medals for us. So he is considered as one of the best player of our country, India. So this is a story all about Major Dhyanchand Singh. Major Dhyanchand Singh is considered to be one of the greatest hockey player of all time. Major Dhyanchand Singh is one of the greatest hockey player of all time. He was part of the gold-winning Indian hockey team in 3 Olympic Games. He was the part of gold-winning Indian hockey team in which they won 3 medals, 3 gold medals in Olympic Games. Let us read more about him. So let us read more about him. How his journey went. It was the finals of the Punjab Indian Infantry Hockey Tournament in Jhelum, India. It was the time in Jhelum, India, where in Punjab Indian Infantry. Infantry means the branch of the army that fights on foot. So it was the final of the Punjab Indian Infantry Hockey Tournament in Jhelum, where in India. Dhyanchand's side was losing the match by 2 goals. Dhyanchand's side was losing the match only by 2 goals. With only 4 minutes to go, his commanding officer called out, "Aage badho jawan, kuch to karo dhyan." Go forward soldier, do something dhyan. With only 4 minutes left to go to finish the match, they have only 4 minutes. At that moment, his commanding officer is the senior officer who is the charge of any players. Here he is the charge of Dhyan. So he speak out that to motivate him, "Aage badho jawan, kuch to karo Dhyan." Dhyanchand did go on to do something. Dhyanchand has to do something to win the match. He scored 3 goals in 4 minutes and led his team to victory. How many goals they want to win the match? They only won 2 goals, but Dhyan Chand scored 3 goals in the left 4 minutes. Remaining 4 minutes, he scored 3 goals and won the match. Dhyan Chand Singh was born in the state of Uttar Pradesh in India on 29 August 1905. When was Dhyan Chand born? Dhyan Chand born on 29 August 1905. Remember the date, students? And where? In the state of Uttar Pradesh. His father, Subedar Sameshwar Dutt Singh, played hockey in the army. His father name is Subedar. Subedar is the rank in Indian Army, and his father name is Sameshwar Dutt Singh. Played hockey in the army. Dhyan Singh's family had to frequently move to different places where his father was transferred on duty. As we all know that in army, we have to move from here to there, here to another place. We don't know when we have to we get the transfer and we have to move from here to there. So just like that, Dhyan Chand's father also frequently moved to different places from here to there. So now moving to the next page. His schooling suffered as a result and he stopped going to school after he completed class 6. His schooling suffered a lot by this transferring from here to there, from one place to another. So he stopped going to school after class 6. The family finally settled in a city called Jhansi, where Dhyan's father got a small piece of land to build a house. Young Dhyan did not show any special interest in sports, though he loved wrestling. Not in hockey, but he loved wrestling. In fact, his hockey career had quite an ordinary beginning. He is not passionate about hockey at young age. At his young age, he is not passionate, but it's quite ordinary, simple, normally. He just play hockey like we do. We play any kind of sports whenever we get the chance. Like this, he played hockey. Dhyan and other youngsters used to cut a leaf of a date palm each and pull off the fronds. Dhyan and other friends of Dhyan used to cut a leaf of a palm and from each side of the fronds, mean in the middle edge of the leaf, with a curve at its end, this palm leaf stem would become a makeshift hockey stick and they would play with a ball made up from old rags. And with a curve at its end, this palm leaf turned into a makeshift. Here makeshift means when we do something that is not permanent, only to use for a short period or short time. So a palm leaf turned into hockey stick and they would play with that, with the ball made from rags. Old rags means old cloths. Okay, here rags means cloths. Old cloths
they played hockey. In 1922, at the age of 17, Dhyan Singh joined the Indian Army. Students, please remember all the dates when Dhyan Chand Singh born and when he played his first game and where. Like this, you have to remember, okay? So, in 1922, at the age of 17, Dhyan Singh joined the Indian Army. At the age of, early age of Dhyan Chand, right? 17 is very early. But at that time, it is just quite normal for all people that he joined the Indian Army. He was a sepoy of the 14th Punjab Regiment. He was the sepoy. Sepoy is a rank in Indian Army and where of the 14th Punjab Regiment. Regiment is a group of army. While serving in the regiment, he came in contact with Subedar Major Bhole Tiwari. When he was doing his duty and doing serving his nation, he just came in contact with Subedar Major Bhole Tiwari. Major is another post in Indian Army, and he came in contact with Bhole Tiwari. Major Tiwari was very fond of hockey and was a good player himself. Major Bhole Tiwari was very fond of, he always looking to play that hockey, and he was a good player himself. He recognized the talent in Dhyan Singh. He saw the talent of playing hockey in Dhyan Singh, because at the young age, Dhyan Chand used to play hockey with his friends. Right? He became Dhyan's guru, and his influence laid the foundations of Dhyan's amazing sports career. Now, he became Dhyan's guru, and his influence laid the foundation, means the basics in this that beginning of his career, for which of Dhyan's amazing sports career. Because Dhyan Chand was at his young age, he was not passionate about to play hockey, but his guru, means his Bhole Tiwari, recognized that talent in Dhyan Chand. Dhyan Chand play hockey very well. Tiwari and Dhyan Chand had no fixed time to play. They had no fixed time to play because we don't know when we called up for having some refugees and that terrorist attacks. We don't know at that time. So they had no fixed time to play. Dhyan Chand had to pay attention to army duties and could not find enough time to practice hockey during the day. So Dhyan Chand had to pay attention for his army duties as well. So he could not get enough time to play hockey at daytime. So he practiced alone on the field at night. While they rested, his army mates could hear him hitting the ball for hours at a time. Well, all the people, all the army mates, when all they are rested at that time, Dhyan Chand Singh is hitting his ball and practice his game for hour and hour. The legend of Dhyan Chand and his unbelievable feats on the hockey field had begun. From that time, the legends of Dhyan Chand and his unbelievable feats on hockey field had begun. Means his career began from that time only. In 1926, Dhyan Chand played his first match for India and New Zealand. When did he play his first match? In 1926, Dhyan Chand played his first match. For whom? For India and New Zealand. Beginning an international career that lasted 22 years. Beginning and not a national career but international career that lasted for 22 years. Dhyan Chand won gold medals at the Olympic Games in Amsterdam 1922, Los Angeles 1932, and as captain in Berlin 1936. Dhyan Chand won 3 gold medals for India in Amsterdam in 1922, Amsterdam, Los Angeles in 1932, and as a captain in Berlin when in 1936. Dhyan Chand scored 36 goals in 12 Olympic matches. Dhyan Chand scored 36 goals in how many Olympic matches? In 12 Olympic matches. An average of 3 goals in each match. Dhyan Chand could control the ball so well with the hockey stick that his opponents thought there was some mischief at work. Dhyan Chand has a very good control over his ball. So the opponent team of Dhyan Chand thought that there was something wrong with the work and with stick also. The Dutch broke his stick to check if there was a magnet inside. The Japanese thought there was a glue on it. So the Dutch broke the stick of Dhyan Chand because they thought that the opponent team thought that there was something wrong with his stick. So Dhyan Chand's stick and check if there was any magnet inside or not. And the Japanese people thought that there was a glue on stick. Dhyan Chand's magical stick work drew crowds to the hockey field. Dhyan Chand's magical stick works drew crowds in the hockey field. His skilled stick work and amazing ball control left fellow players and spectators awestruck. He earned the nickname Hockey Wizard. He has so good control over his ball. So when his skill works so amazing and he has so nice control over his ball, and so he left his fellow players and spectators awestruck. Awestruck means they were just surprised how the Dhyan Chand played so well with his stick and how he controlled his ball. He earned the nickname Hockey Wizard. So from that time only he earned the name Hockey Wizard. When he played at the Berlin Olympics, a German newspaper carried a banner headline, "The Olympic complex now has a magic show too." When he played the Berlin Olympics, a German newspaper carried a tagline or headline that the Olympic complex has a magic show also, because Dhyan Chand's hockey stick is just a magical stick for who watch his match and how he control his ball. Dhyan Chand believed in being the best. Dhyan Chand believed in being the best. As a great sportsman, he never lost his temper on the field, but he certainly had the will to win. As a great sportsman, Dhyan Chand never lost his temper. He never shows his anger on field, but he certainly has the will, has the desire to win the match. Dhyan Chand played with excellent team spirit. टीम स्पिरिट मीन्स ही प्लेड विद हिज टीम ओनली ही डोंट प्ले अलोन लाइक ही इज स्कोरिंग अलोन ही हैज अ वेल एक्सलेंट टीम स्पिरिट ही रेस्पेक्टेड हिज टीम मेट्स इवन दो ही वॉज टैलेंटेड ही नेवर बूस्टेड और शोड ऑफ He was talented. All knows that he was very talented, but he never used any disrespectful word towards his teammates, and he always respect his teammates. And he never boosted or showed off anything. He played selflessly. If he found that one of his teammates was in the better position to score, he would immediately flick the ball to the well-placed player. He played selflessly. He played like he has no selfish mode to win the match or to win the trophy. He played his match selflessly. If he found that someone of his teammate has a better place to score well, so he just flicked the ball, means just pass the ball to the player so that they can score. Hockey is a game of 11 players, not of one individual, he always said. Hockey is the game of 11 players in hockey. There are 11 players in hockey. So it is not the plane of individual, it is a game of 11 players. At the age of 51, Dhyan Chand retired from the army as a major. Dhyan Chand retired as the army from the army as a major. Major is a rank in Indian Army. The government of India honored him that year by awarding him the Padma Bhushan, India's third highest civilian honor. And then at the age of 51, Dhyan Chand retired from the army as a major, and government of India honored him by a award. Padma Bhushan is the third highest civilian honor of India. Dhyan Chand breathed his last on 3rd December 1979 in Delhi. Dhyan Chand died on 3rd December 1979 in Delhi. A year after his death, the Indian Postal Survey issued a commemorative stamp in his honor. And after that year, when he died, after 1 year, a stamp in the memory of or as a tribute to someone great achievement. So a commemorative stamp means a stamp in the memory of or as a tribute to someone's great achievement. They are just issued in name of Dhyan Chand. The Dhyan Chand National Stadium in New Delhi is named in his honor. There is a stadium in Delhi which named after Dhyan Chand in his honor, and his birthday 29 August is celebrated as a national sports day in India. The president gives away sports awards such as Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Arjuna Award and Dronacharya Award on this day at Rashtrapati Bhavan. And the president of our India gave away some sports award such as Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Arjuna Award and Dronacharya Award on Rashtrapati Bhavan for the sportsman who did something good and great achievement in sports. In 2002, a Dhyan Chand Award for Lifetime Achievement in Sports and Game was introduced to honor those sportspersons who have not only contributed to sports through their performance but continue to contribute to the promotion of sports after retirement for an active sporting career. So in 2002, one award is introduced in honor to that sports person who has been retired but still having some active sporting career. Man, they are also giving some advice, some good for sports person, and they had the sports person who was not in good financial condition. So this award is given to that sports person, and the name of that award is Dhyan Chand Award for Lifetime Achievement in Sports and Games. The opening sentence of Dhyan Chand's autobiography reads, I am a common man and then a soldier. And there was a book and the sentence on that biography reads that the first sentence of that biography is that autobiography is that I am a common man and then a soldier. It has been my training from my very childhood to avoid limelight. Limelight means name, fame and that publicity like this which actor, actress do. So he is always training that away from that limelight and publicity. I have chosen a profession where I have been taught to be a soldier and nothing beyond that. So he has taken his profession as he always taught to be a soldier and nothing beyond that. But he was not so common after all. But he was no common after all because he was a great player and he was a great man also, a human being. So he was not a common man for all. His skills was the stuff of myth and legends. There will never be another like him. Dhyan Chand's brother Roop Singh, son Ashok Kumar, nephew Chandrasekhar and granddaughter Sneha Singh too had the privilege of representing the national hockey team at Olympics and various World Cup games. The Singh family has won 5 Olympic gold medals, 1 Olympic bronze, 1 World Cup gold, 1 World Cup silver and 1 World Cup bronze medal. They have won these medals, 5 Olympic gold medals and 1 Olympic bronze also and 1 World Cup gold also, 1 World Cup silver and 1 World Cup bronze medal they have won. So this is the story of Dhyan Chand. So remember all the dates when Dhyan Chand won in 1905 and when he played his first game and when he entered in Indian Army 1922 and when he played his first game in 1926, second 1928 and third 1932 and he won first gold medal in 1928. So this was the story of Dhyan Chand. I hope you like this scripts and please log in into our Lofty ID and write your question answers from there. I already uploaded your question answers of chapter number 2 in your Lofty ID.